beautiful listeners, welcome to True Heart Collector. In this video today, I am going to give you how to draw a Thinking Card, how you can actually learn all these things at your living room, at your home, at your bedroom, wherever you may be. Nice to meet you on my channel, and please, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, right there, can you kindly do so? And the bell, oh yes, the bell. Now you click on the bell, that way you'll be able to notify each time I am posting a new video. So today in this video, I am giving you how to draft a fitting skirt. Oh yes, like this. All this has been done by my student. She has been a very brilliant student, and many other more that I may not mention here. Just know you have done a beautiful work out there. Congrats to you, those who are able to go through with all this process learning from me. So today again, you as well, you can be like them, and you can make yourself on outfit wherever you may be. So stick around and do not go anywhere. Watch this video up to the end, and then you'll be able to learn so much more with me. I am so privileged to give you this at your own disposal, wherever you may be. So kindly, let's get right away to the work. I'm going to take you with a measurement. I think this is going to help us how to figure out how to measure clients, okay? Especially if you're doing a fitting skirt. So this is my waist, and this is my hip, and then I'm going to get waist to hip, and then waist to the length, and so. So let's get to work. This is her waist. This is her hips. This is her waist to hip, okay? And then I'll continue to length. So, that's all. That is the only measurement you will need for the drafting of your fitting skirt. So let's get right away now that we have gone to the measurement. Okay, so let's get to the measurements, and let me get to what other requirements I would need. First of all, I would need a top measure, which is right here, and I would need a ruler, which is right here, and then I would need a marker pen. And for you, I would advise that you use a pencil, and as well, I will need a drafting paper. Ahead, I will need to write my measurements down. So the measurement that I meant I will be needing will be my waist, which is 28. I will need my hips, which is 38. I will need my hip to waist, which is 9 inch. I would need my waist to length, which is 24 inch. So these are the basically the measurement I would need more for my fitting skirt. So once I get my I hope paper. I do not know which paper do you use for drafting, but this is what I use for drafting. So for now, I would need to rule my paper. I'll do 2 inches on all the sides, 2 inches. So this will give me the point where I can rule my paper accordingly. So beautiful. So the next thing I am going to do is, now I've finished ruling my paper and I have my measurement right here. So the next thing I am going to do is to get my measurement and do the calculations. So I'll put my measurement here and I'll get my hip measurement to get my block, which is going to be like this. So from 1 to 2, I'll use half of the hip. So that means hip divided by 2 plus 2 inches. Maybe you can add another 1 inch for ease. That is if you do not really need it so fitting on you. But of course also the drafting of this depend on the material you're going to use. So if you're using the kitenge that is not so stretching, I would really need you not to add in a lot of ease. You can just add 2 inches, that will give you block and then the allowance, full stop. But if you know that your material doesn't stretch, then maybe you can go on and give it ease. That is 1 inch on your block. That is 1 to 2. Okay, so let's get 1 to 2 and then we get our block. So let's say this is 1 right there, and then I am going to get that 2. So for me to get that 2, then I need to make sure 38 divided by 2. So I usually like to use my tape measure. I'm going to go to 38. So from 38, I'll put it right here, and then I'll go up to there, which is there. Okay, so when I get my answer, it is 19. So from here, I'll put 19, and then I'll make sure that I add 1 to 8, which is 21. Get that? So that is in case if you don't want an ease and your material is good. But if your material is a little bit hard, then maybe you can add it in 1 inch for an ease. But that would really be good for me. So I can go ahead and rule this to my length. So first of all, I need to now go on and find my skirt length. So my skirt length, I say that it is 24. So I'll take my tape measure from this point up to 24, which is here, and then I'll add 2 inches for my seam allowance. I keep doing this, that way I can make a straight line. This is 24 and this is 2 inches, which is makes it in total 26. So from there I'll take
my measurement which I've done here, which is from 0.1 to 0.2, which is 20. Let's call this 0.2, which is from here to there. We are saying that the 38, we divide it by 2 plus 2, give us 21. So this 21 is, I'm going to bring it up to here to my hemming. So this is my length and this is my hemming. And this is my waist. 21. So I'll get my roller and make sure that I mark it from that point to 21. So this is my block for my skirt. Now I'll come right away to my waist to hip, which is 9 inches. I'll take my ruler, my tape measure, and mark 9 inches here and 9 inches right there. Beautiful. So this is done already. So what I can tell you, so even on this hip you can use 9 or 10, it depends on how tall this person is. So from there now I can go on and divide this block into two. This block, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So I have my block into 6 and I can divide it into 2. How do I divide that? I just need to make sure I get half of 1 to 2. So that is, if I divide 21 divide by 2, let us see how many I get. I'll be able to get 10 and a half. So I'll put 10 and a half and give it a middle point here. I come in 10 and a half, 10 and a half, and then I come down here. I keep doing this marking, that way I can get my correct, accurate, straight line. I do get issues with my students when they don't give me correct, accurate, straight lines. So this is really now my middle line. So to middle line, to my point 1, I'll drop down 1 inch. Okay, so to my point 2, I'll drop down 0.5 inch. I hope you can see that, yes. So I'll give a curve to these lines. So when my roll has a curve, I'll give a curve to this line. So from there, I'll make sure that I give it a curve. Beautiful. And then from here, I'll make sure that I give it a curve. Good. Because the reason why I'm doing this, our body shape is not straight. Our body has a beautiful shape, and when you study your body, you get to understand how beautiful actually you are. So when I am drafting, I get to see how our body looks like, and that's how we do the stepping according to the body. Most people, you find that they will do the straight waist, and it gives you the waist, and that's where now you find that the whole outfit may look funny. Especially this is a skirt I am constructing. What I'm constructing right now is a fitting skirt block. I hope all you can be able to understand that and never get it right. Beautiful. So this is the block I am doing. It's a 15 skirt block. For those of you who may not be able to see So from there, what I am going to do next is to get my waist. My waist is 28. So if I divide, I will divide 28 by 4, and let's see how it will give us. So from here I'll put 7, I'll make sure I add in 2 wounds. One is for that, one is for seam allowance. So from this point, now this is my waist curved line, not the other one, on this point. From this point I'll do 7 inch. And then I'll add 1, 2, which is right there. You see that? So this is my hip roller, the one you have seen. And then I'll get my hip roller. I'll make sure that I bring this right here. You see that? Exactly. And that is what I'll get. So my skirt will have that. The same thing I will do to this point here for the back. So for your information, if you are lost, this is on fold and this is front pattern. And this is back. Our skirt is going to have slit, so it will not have really the off. Back will be on open, and there is going to be a seam line at the back. So front will not have a seam line. Okay, so the same thing I will do for the back. I'll make sure I put 7 inch. Remember, I'm using now this line, not the other one. Okay, I'm using this line, not the other one. Again, this is my 7, then I'll add 2 inch here, which is 1, 2. Again, I will use my hip roller. And I will. Beautiful. So this is how my stepping is going to come. So remember, from 1 to 2, we did our hip. So from here to here, I just need to make sure my 38, I'll divide it by 4 plus 1. And you get to understand how we get the exact thing. So okay, also from here to here I'll do 38 divided by 4 plus 1. And then I'll get it right there. So yeah, basically I don't really need to do so much work. Now, so for those of you who have no idea how actual our skirt looks like, this is how our skirt is looking like. But this is a skirt I am constructing. Okay, so you find this is my waist, and this is my dad, and this is my dad that is coming up, and this is the front. I hope you can be able to see, so I may not be that much artist. And then I'm coming to the back. So this is for a zipper, and this is for the, we have also button on the waistband, and our skirt will have a waistband, and then our skirt will have a slit, which is the overlap, it will overlap exactly what you have seen here. I hope you can be able to understand this, and this is our back. So you could see that our skirt is not much straight from hip. It's not like this according to our skirt here. So that means there is a fitting that went down here on our bottom of the skirt. So how do we able to get this to our drafting? So this is what we do. And we know that we draft our patterns always on fold. And this is what you get. So first of all, you need to have that here. You need to make sure that you have that right here. So for us to get that, I need to make sure that my actual waist, which is 7, I'll divide it by 2, which is 7.5. So 7.5, and then I'll make my line down 5 inches, which is right here, and then I'll do 0.5, 0.5. And I get my roller and put it down. Exactly. So that is my dart, which is this one here. Now the bottom part, how are we going to do the bottom part, which is here? And now we are drafting it on floor. So our bottom part is here with my hemming allowance, which is right here. What I am going to do is I'm going to move 1 inch in. It depends on, you can do 1.5, you can do 2 inches. This comes in desirable shape. You can leave it straight, you can shape it, but to me shaping can make it so more desirable. So I'll do half a 1 inch 1 inch, and my 1 inch, I'll make sure I bring this to here, and then I bring this from the hip to my desirable shape. So at the end of the day, you find that this is what I am going to get. This is the pattern I am going to get right from this point, right from here to here, and then to here. So please, if you like this video, give it a thumb up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, kindly can you do so. Thank you so much for watching this video. So my last part on my design is the slit. My slit goes to the back pattern. Okay, so if this is my slit and I want to put here, so what the normal slit also is, it is, first of all, it has tears and zipper. So I will do one inch for a zipper allowance, 1 inch here, 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch, and I will reduce it down. So the next thing I am going to do for my slit is to go from my hemming 8 inches up. So from this to there, I will do 8 inches, and then from this hemming, I will make sure I will do 1 inch out. So this is 1 inch zipper allowance, and this is my this become my slit allowance. But a slit can go beyond that. That is if the client wants it very long, but our slit is going to be overlapped. So this is my slit allowance. This is as simple as it is. So please, if you can try this, practice always makes perfect. When you practice this, you'll be able to get something better and good. Thank you so much for watching this, and the next video will be how to cut and construct our skirt. skirt, and then together with the waist. I will give you how to drop the waist. Never and ever make a long line, a long rope, and you just round it on your waist. No, 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 no. Make sure you always draft waistband for a fitting skirt. That way it can fit you properly.
If you haven't subscribed to my channel, ooh, what are you waiting for? You may miss a lot. May you please just click there and tap on the bell. That way you'll be reminded that every time I post on a video that I have posted something, and it will notify you right away, there and then. Thank you so much for sticking with me, and thank you so much for always following me on my social media, on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much on my TikTok. Thank you so much. And on my Instagram, thank you so much. And Facebook is very active for you as well. You can follow me on Facebook page, True Heart Collection, TikTok, True Heart Collection, Twitter, True Heart Collection. Oh, that is really, really my love.